let's see if we can get the scanner through the hole then.
Now Nick can scan the back as well as the front.
I can get round probably, I would say, approaching 60% of the skull here and quite a large amount of the crown. Right, have a go at the eye socket.
Can't wait to see this.
It's pretty amazing.
Scan things to millimeter, sub-millimeter accuracy if we wanted to.
I can't believe I'm actually getting around the back side of this. I didn't think we were going to reach this.
That's it. After an hour of laser scanning, the Bealey skull now has a virtual twin.
No skull.
Oh my words. Look at that! Okay, this is extraordinary. For over 100 years, this skull has been rumoured to belong to William Shakespeare. Now it can be analysed by forensic anthropologist Caroline Wilkinson. As an expert in craniofacial reconstruction, Caroline works with the police to help identify murder victims. She can determine whether its age and sex make it a potential match for Shakespeare.
The skull gives you quite a lot of information about an individual. So we can tell whether the individual is male or female, we can look at the age that they died, and we can look at a broad ancestry category. And then in more detail, the features of their face and their facial appearance. And see, we've got a pretty good 3D shape. The first thing is that from a broad ancestry point of view, this is consistent with a white European.
Shakespeare, white European. So far, so good.
Then the next thing we would do is an assessment of how old the person was when they died. What we tend to look at within anthropology are the teeth, because the wear of the teeth will be directly related to the age of the individual.
Kevin also had photos taken by a crime scene photographer, so that Caroline could examine the teeth in detail.
On this individual, the bone has resorbed, especially around the front where the incisors were, and there's no indication that there's sockets there.
So these were teeth that were lost in life?
Yeah. From this skull, I would expect them to be in their 70s, because we don't have teeth in the upper jaw.
It's unlikely that Shakespeare had lost all his teeth by the age of 52 when he died.
The next thing to look at is the brow.
And there's more that doesn't quite match.
In male skulls, you tend to see a bulge just where the eyebrows sit. And you can see on this skull that we don't have a bulge of bone. We've got quite a smooth and upright forehead.
The shape of the eye orbits also looks suspiciously female.
From looking at the information that we do have, it looks more like a female skull.
The suggestion of age, the suggestion of femaleness, it's pretty clear, isn't it? I mean, on the balance of probability.
It is. I mean, I would be somewhat cautious.
But the balance of probabilities,
I'd be going for no.
Caroline's reconstructed the face of the mystery skull, which apparently belonged to an unknown woman in her 70s. As far as we know, William Shakespeare wasn't female, was he?
Not as far, no. That would be a turn-up for the books.
The legend of the Bealey skull turns out to be just that, a tall tale. It's laid to rest one of the myths, but hasn't answered the mystery hanging over Shakespeare's strange tomb. To do that, we need to see the final GPR results.
Some calls are too important to drop. Keep your promises with Vodafone, the UK's number one network for voice.
Surf talking. Long line. Breeze blowing.